Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well. And if you're new to my channel, my name is Kat. Welcome, I'm glad you're here. So I'm making this video today because I want to catch up with you guys, let you know what I'm up to, what I'm not up to, give you all the tea. I do have stories to tell you, well, a story time, so we'll get into that later. But first and foremost, I missed you guys. And the first question I've been asked from close friends and everyone like that who listens to my podcast is, where the hell have I been and why have I not been recording for the podcast? Well, as I said in my last episode, I actually started school. I did like a summer class. It was for anatomy and phys. So I was taking that. It was about 5 weeks long. So I decided to cut the podcast for the moment temporarily so I can focus on the class and do well, because I don't think I ever got to tell you guys why I'm going back to school. So I'm gonna tell you now. I'm actually taking prerequisites for a dental hygiene program. I'm going to apply to two, so let's see how that goes. I'm actually excited. And if most of you guys know or don't know, I'm a dental assistant. I've been doing it for about 7 years now, and I kind of just feel like I've leveled up so much that I've reached like a plateau. Like there's no more that I can do to further my career. So because of that, I decided the route of dental hygiene. Fun fact, I always actually wanted to be a dentist, but with all the debt that dental students have to take on and then the reality of paying that back, God bless their souls, because it can't be me. I can't be in a crazy debt like that. I know some dental students that are over $500,000 in debt. Like, that is just so crazy to me. And I don't know if it's worth that. But I do have a love and passion for the dental field, and I feel like anything I do in it, I will succeed in it. So yeah, guys, that is the plan. I'm trying to apply to a dental hygiene program, and I'm hoping to start by 2023. Fingers crossed. You guys will definitely know. As for the podcast though, I am going to pick it back up. I am going to take another class starting September, but I think I might change it to a bi-weekly schedule then, just because I don't know what this class entails and everything like that. The summer class was more vigorous. I had classes Monday through Thursday for 4 hours of the day, 8 to 12. So it was like super intense. And then on top of it, I had to work. So, long story short is we're still gonna continue the podcast. Your girl did not leave the podcast hanging at all. So I think the last thing that I talked to you guys about, like I did a vlog on it and I mentioned on the podcast, was that I was doing rowing, and rowing has been amazing. I am still doing it. I keep up with it. I think it's such a great cardio workout, honestly, and I'm not a runner, so it works out for me, because I'll do the occasional run or two in the summer and fall and stuff like that if I'm in the mood. But honestly, rowing is just that much vigorous, probably even more. I honestly enjoy it so much. I didn't know I was gonna like it as much as I do, but I do. I also did want to tell you guys the anatomy class that I was taking, I did pass. I got an A in the class, so I'm so happy about that. Just because it was a lot of work and very tedious and constant go 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 test every week, so it was a lot. Things started overlapping, so I'm just happy it's over with. But I did want to update you guys on what's been going on. Dating wise, I haven't gone on a date. I've talked to guys, sure, but talking really goes nowhere. But I do have to tell you about this one guy. He is so dry. I'm talking about drier than the freaking Moroccan deserts. I don't even know if those are dry, but this man is dry as hell. drive to the point that, perfect example, like, he sounds like he wants to hang out or he'll ask me, but yet he doesn't initiate it at all. He just asks. And it's like the weirdest thing to me because I'm like, dude, why are you asking if you're not gonna like execute an action? Like, what is happening here? And why are you wasting my time at this point? Like, now you're just texting to text and it's stupid. It's annoying at this point. So this guy this week, actually, he hit me up on Tuesday and was like, oh, are you free this week? What day during the week? Yada, yada, yada. So I told him, yeah, you know, I'm off this whole week. Because I was off this whole week. And I'm free anytime. The only day that I have something going on is Thursday. Because I have a row scheduled from 6 to 6:45. This man decides to text me on Thursday asking about, hey, how are you? What are you doing this afternoon? Bitch. The audacity, first of all, like, how the fuck? I can't. So I hit him back up and I was like, well, today I have my row class, which was my last message to him. Like, I don't understand the logic behind the thinking of a man, because honestly, like, who does that? You had all week. I told you I'm free all week, but Thursday, the one day that I actually have something going on, you want to ask me what I'm doing in the afternoon? Sir, goodbye. You're not paying attention and you clearly do not care because it's your time, apparently. So that shit was annoying. Needless to say, this guy really is just not even worth the entertainment, to be honest. And he's not the only one. I feel like men do this a lot. Like, they'll start a conversation with a woman. I don't know if you fucking feel bad or what, but like, if you don't want to talk to them and you really don't want to hang out with them, guess what? You don't have to do it. Like, nobody's getting butt hurt when you don't even know the person. You don't owe them anything. I don't understand the freaking logic. Now, guys, this next story that I'm about to tell you, I'm just flabbergasted, I guess you can say, because I never go out. And when I do go out, it's usually with girlfriends. We go out for drinks or something. And I haven't even done that in months. So the fact that I went out took a lot to begin with. Now let me tell you who I went out with. So I actually made a friend in class. He became my study partner. We would study and like kind of just review everything, ask each other questions in different ways to see if we knew the material for the exam the next day. And he became cool. And I have to add, he never ever tried anything or anything like that. He would always talk about his girlfriend, inform the class about his girlfriend. And that's how we even became cool, because he told me about his girlfriend and how she's in the dental hygiene program, yada, yada, yada. Or she was in it and she graduated from it and she's a hygienist, whatever. That's how we became cool initially. So then we started to study together every time before an exam, whatever. We passed the class, we both get A's, we're excited. And we already had talked about like, oh, maybe like if we get an A, we'll go out, get like celebratory drinks and, you know, like cheers to that we got an A, because he was like 30 and it was our first time back in school after so many years. So we made that the plan. I completely forgot about the plan because the class ended Wednesday and he wanted to meet up Friday night. So I completely forgot about the plan. I had a row class that night, everything. He had called me around 5 to remind me like, oh, you still wanna go out to celebrate our A's and get drinks? And I was like, oh yeah, sure. And it was early enough that I was like, okay, whatever. So when he called and we were having a little conversation, I was like, hey, I know you have your girlfriend, but I don't wanna be disrespectful. Like, I know how it is. I have guy friends. Like, it's cool. We don't go out or anything like that. I was also trying to get out of it because I was not trying to go out. But anyways, I didn't want to be disrespectful to nobody's relationship or anything like that. And I told him that. And he, red flag number one, he got a little offended that I would even bring up his girlfriend.
Hold up. Wait a minute. Something ain't right.
I was like, dude, I'm just asking because I have guy friends. Their girlfriends won't allow something like that or they're not cool with it, which I understand. I'm not gonna sit here and cry about it. Like, I don't care. I could care less. So he was like, no, I have a lot of girls that are friends. My girl don't care, blah, blah, blah. Okay, whatever. I know my instincts. I knew that was a load of shit. But anyways, we end up going out, getting drinks. I think it was like 8:30. We go get drinks. This man, we were talking about school, the class, whatever. I'm watching this man. He goes up to the bartender, how he's talking to the bartenders, how he's talking to the waitress, how he's talking to the hostess. I'm watching. I'm a people watcher, so I'm very analytical. So I see how he's talking to everyone and everything like that, and I'm just laughing because in my head I'm like, this dude has a whole ass girlfriend and he's acting reckless. Fine, whatever. So then while we're having our drinks, you know, shooting the shit, he literally starts like throwing compliments at me. He's like, oh, you're so beautiful, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, excuse me, what? Like, you have never, ever come across and said something like this. Like, please don't start now. Like, we're cool, let's keep it there. You know, I shot that shit down. So he got the message the first time, but I guess a few drinks in, he felt good or whatever, that he felt like he could compliment me more or feel ballsy enough that towards the end of the night, he decided he wanted to try and make a move. But I'm too swift with it, bro. Like, no. I've swerved so many kisses in my life that it's not even funny. Anyways, so he tried to go in for a kiss, quick cheek action, like, nope, not happening. I already know the drill. And I literally practically scolded him. I'm like, do you know that you are wrong? 1000% wrong. You're in a whole ass relationship and you're about to act up. And he literally got so offended. Like, I don't understand how he even had the audacity to get offended. Like, honestly, I wonder where people find the audacity. I question it, to be honest. Anyways, so we were going at it, like, arguing, because I told him, I'm like, dude, you have a girlfriend. I don't even know how long you've dated her, but it sounds like you've dated a long time. And you are wrong. Like, you were flirting with this, this, this. And he's like, dude, I'm single until I'm married, da 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 da. And I'm like, bro, like, what kind of mindset? He's a 30-year-old man and the mindset is of a 20-year-old. I just don't understand. Anyways, long story short, he ended up leaving and I ended up getting in my car. I look at my freaking phone. My Apple Watch, first of all, died. So anything that was coming in, I didn't know. I opened up my phone when I got in my car and I look in my phone. I have literally like 6 to 7 missed calls from some number. And then as I'm looking at my phone, the number calls again.
Oh, hell no!
I pick up the phone. Is this guy's girlfriend? Like, mind blown. I was flabbergasted. I pick up and, you know, I'm all about being honest and everything like that. And I talked to her. She was like an interrogator though. She just had question, 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 question. She just wanted to know what she wanted to know. And that was it. But obviously, like, I tried to tell her, like, you know, everything that I could, because that man is a piece of shit. And I was so upset for her because I've been in a situation like that where I've had to call somebody. And like, for me, absolutely fucked up. So after she got all the answers that she wanted, she then was like, okay, thanks, bye, and hung up. And then the audacity of this man to call me the next day to be like, yo, you talked to my girl, what did she say? Excuse me, sir, you need to go somewhere. Anyways, with that, I ended up blocking him because, like, what the hell? I don't ever want to talk to you again, first of all. Like, I've never met a guy that's such a piece of shit. I mean, don't get me wrong. There's guys out there that literally will go out and do it and not say nothing at all and cheat and everything. But, like, I don't know. The mindset to, like, state you have a girlfriend but then try and do something with somebody else, like, I can't fathom it. Anyways, that's what I get for going out, I guess. This is why I can't. I really cannot with like today's age of dating or talking or anything and like the mindset of men. Like for a 30-year-old man, how are you thinking, I'm single until I'm married, I'm not committed? But bro, you are committed. You've been in the relationship for a long ass time. You're fucking committed as fuck. You should be at least, but you're not. And it was just like disgusting to see how he was talking. He's like, yo, I talked to my girls, you know, I was messing with this and that. It's just gross. But anyways, like I was saying, guys, I'm so excited that I'm back, and I wanted to just start it off with this video and a little story time and tell you guys what's up. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video of me chatting with you guys, and I will see you guys on the next one. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye.